Japanese clay that's made from pulverized paper. So it is like paper mache. And they add a fluid to it so it's squishy. And you can mold it and sculpt it. I use small dental tools to sculpt with it. And it's an air dry clay. It takes about 48 hours to dry. And then from there you can sand it or carve it. The body's made of cloth and it's stuffed cotton, and I've wired them also so you can pose them. And all her clothes are either hand dyed or painted. And then I add little baubles and flowers and stuff to design the fabric. The furniture is made out of the old fashioned paper mache, where you just layer on paper. They're all different. I tried to make them look sort of like the old fashioned Mexican. If done right, it's so strong they even used to use it to make boats. It's very strong. If you think about it, it's a tree. The little sculptures I did, the very small ones, are made of polymer clay. It goes in the oven. It only takes about 30 minutes. And then when it comes out, I hand paint them all and then varnish them. This is a little tiger. His name is Bear. That's Holly and Bear. She came from one of my little sketches. She came to life, and I also did her in a painting over here. The name of the painting is Redbird. She's kind of otherworldly. If you look closely at her, you know, her face is kind of elongated a little bit. Her ears are pointed. The fairies, they all have a story. They belong to the same clan. This one is Story. She keeps the legend of the clan. This one is the youngest one. Her name is Mika. And that's Pippa. She's the musician. This is the queen. She has on the front of her a paper mache tree because she originated from the mother tree. I have a story. On our property, we have a tree that I call the mother tree. Uh-huh. It's actually hollow, but it's alive. So I imagine that it's like a womb, and these magical creatures came out of it. She's directly from the tree. And it's a beautiful oak.